or it is also called ESR spectroscopy. Right, so EPR means your electron paramagnetic resonance spectroscopy, and ESR is also like the other name, that is ESR correspond to your electron spin resonance spectroscopy. Now this comes under your inorganic spectroscopy, and like question is, can be asked from here, like two parts are major part of it. One is finding out the number of hyperfine lines, and the other one is like the about that Landé G factor. So about G parallel, G perpendicular. So I'll try to explain all those things in this video, and I have already written it down so that I can save some of your time. And also we'll be solving questions which have been asked in previous year CSIR NET and GATE exams, right? So I have taken 3-4 questions and we'll be solving them in this video after explaining everything. Okay, so when I talk about this EPR spectroscopy, this is like so these were the two names which both correspond to the same thing, and this spectroscopy is used to study about the materials which have unpaired number of electrons. So this is very important, that the electron number of electrons should be like, it should have unpaired electron, then only it will be EPR active. Now based on similar basic concept of your NMR spectroscopy, but here electrons spin is excited instead of a nuclei spin. So if you remember what I have taught in that NMR spectroscopy, what happens there, that in a presence of external magnetic field, your nucleus it gets excited from alpha state to beta state, and that's how like the transition happens and everything there. But over here the electron spin is considered, not the nucleus spin. So that is the major difference between NMR and EPR. Now this is very helpful to study inorganic complexes and organic radicals. So in organic radicals also we have unpaired electrons, so that's why this is also used to study organic radicals along with this inorganic complexes. All right, so this was the introduction part of it. Now before going further, if you are new to the